Hello and welcome to Altia Suite. Today I want to discuss on how you can open an Excel file to scan your model numbers and also your serial numbers on its document. This will be the process of getting us the models and serials with the intention of adding this to our opening stock template, but you don't have to use that template. You can actually open up your own Excel document. You can see here on column A, I've called this my model number, and on column B, I have my serial number. The way the scanner works with these kinds of spreadsheets is all you need to do is make sure that the cell is highlighted where you want to scan. And then what I've done is I've have my barcodes for both my model numbers and my serial numbers accessible. So with my scanner, make sure it's turned on. You need to make sure that the scanner is connected to whatever this document is on. So if it's on your phone, you need to make sure the scanner is connected to your phone. If you're on your laptop or a desktop, you also need to make sure the scanner is connected to those devices. Now, the way this works is I have this model number right here, this WDT model number. So I'm gonna scan that. You can see right there, it automatically scanned that item in there and it moved us down into the next cell. And now I'm gonna take a pause break here. So I don't want to scan my serial number right below it. I want to scan it right here in this section. So you do need to make sure that the cell is connected. It's highlighted to where you want to put the serial number. So now I'm going to go find the serial number for this WDT model number. And I have its serial number right here. It's a little bit long serial number, but I'm going to scan it because it's in barcode form. I'm going to scan it instead of typing it out. Here we go. There we go. So I scanned that barcode with my scan gun and it recorded whatever the barcode added on there. So in this case, the serial number is W7LZY5TRWG. Then from this point, you go to the next one and record the model numbers. So my next model number is this MDB number. So I'm gonna scan that. There we go. Now, you have to be careful not to double scan. Because if you're not careful enough, it will keep on scanning the same thing that you got it pointed at. So whatever barcode that you got the scan gun pointed at is going to be the same thing that it records. So be kind of cautious whenever you're doing this so you don't record the wrong model numbers. But I'm gonna go back to that W or MDB number, and I'm gonna go and find its serial number, which is right down over here. Again, making sure that my cell is selected, scanning that number. There we go. So that's the serial number for that model number. Now I'm going to do the same thing with my other numbers, except I'm just going to scan down. I'm going to scan the rest of my models that I have. They're all right next to me. So I'm going to scan in this one and scan that guy. There we go. I'm going to scan my other model number and that'll add it to my sheet here. There we go. That's the next one. And then I'm going to go find my other two models. I only have six models I'm doing this for. So it's not too big of a list. There's that one. And then I'm gonna get my final one, which is this MVW. There we go. So I just recorded all my model numbers. Now I'm gonna go back and record all my serial numbers. So as you're on a cell, it will move it down after you scan it into the cell. I'm gonna go and find my other serial number. It's an 8815, but I don't want to type that out. I just want to scan it in there. There we go. And basically just gonna connect over here and make sure I have all the serial numbers for my models. Now, if you do have a model that has two different serial numbers, the way you would do that is you would need to list them out as their own little lines and then record what their serial numbers are. So let's say we have two quantity of the same model number, but this is a serial number for that one. There we go. And then we need to record the other serial number or that guy. So same thing, move it over there, completely different serial number, but different model numbers. And then I'll go back and make sure I scan this one for that one. Go make sure that that cursor was selected, and then we scan in our last serial number. Here we go. Oops, too far. Okay, so that's all we really need. We just need to make sure that the scanner is connected to our system, that we have the spreadsheet on, and then it'll scan into the cell whatever you pointed at. All right, and that's how to scan model numbers and serial numbers into your Excel document.